Salil.
Hi.
Welcome to CXO Live.
Thank you.
Tell us three lesser known facts about yourself.
I'm very introverted, but I'm with a lot of people. I need some time to go back and recharge and then kind of come back. So I once interviewed Arthur C. Clarke when I was a journalist in college many, many years ago, which not too many people know about. I was working with Rediff on the net when I was interning with college, and I was doing a story. He'd just written a book, 3001 A Space Odyssey, and there was an Indian scientist who challenged him, and he wasn't doing interviews. He hadn't done interviews for 20 years. He was old away in Sri Lanka then. He was still alive then, and I somehow managed to get his phone number. I was just this persistent and I called him up, and I had the entire newsroom behind me on speaker. Arthur C. Clarke doesn't do interviews. And I told him about this. And I was actually doing physics. And it's one of the few times my undergraduate degree has actually come in handy, because we were actually able to talk about tensor strength. And in a way that he didn't think I was a complete idiot. And we had this great interview, this great conversation, where he actually took me through mathematical equations, referred me to somebody in NASA who could, in the JPL lab in NASA, who could kind of help. So that was a pretty unbelievable experience.
What is the one color you think your personality, you know, would associate with the most?
Probably more red, just right? Driven by, that's just the color of energy. Right. Yeah, I can be, quite driven and quite high energy, especially when I'm at work.
What is your wish list in terms of just doing it, that you want to do these three things?
Sure. So I'd love to run all six marathon majors.
How many have you done?
So I've done three so far. I'm doing my fourth one in September, which is Berlin. And then there are two more that I'd like to do. So that's a little bit of a bucket list. They give you one of these medals if you do all six of them, and that's the one I really want. So that's pretty good. I think the other one is really to play golf on some of the really famous courses. I've played on a whole bunch of them, but there are some of these.
Is there any particular one?
Augusta National would be nice. I'm never going to get there, but it's nice to dream, isn't it?
What is running? Running is what?
Running is a time for myself. It's a time to collect my thoughts. It's a time to get re-energized.
Who was one person who was most surprised when you took to running?
I think one of my managers, one of my former managers, and he ran to me many years ago, and he said, I'm really surprised you do marathons, because marathons involve a lot of persistence and dedication, and you know, just the doggedness of it. And they said, look, I always thought you're a smart guy, but you know, I didn't think you had the discipline to kind of do this whole thing. So he was pretty surprised, I think, in a pleasant way.
Did you surprise yourself?
Oh, massively. Massively. I've never been a runner. I used to play a few sports, but never been one of those.
This is how many years back?
10, 11 years. Before that, I went from zero to started to running. So I was surprised myself, because I never saw myself as somebody who was particularly athletic or particularly fit. I was pretty surprised.
Is there a superstition kind of you follow?
I think the superstition before I run is I want to get out of the left side of my bed. I don't know why. It's always been I've always, you know, you get out of the right side of the bed is the traditional one. Yeah. And at some point it started being contrary and just got out to the right left side of my bed, and I had a great run. And ever since then, in my head, it's get out of the left side of the bed and you're going to have a good run. So sometimes I've gotten back into bed because I got off the right side of the bed, and then gotten back out of the left side. Okay, now it's going to be a good run.
What's your favorite color?
Blue, a dark blue. I just think it's pretty versatile. I don't like to think too much about what it is that I'm wearing, so dark blue pretty much goes with everything. It's the no-brainer. It's the equivalent of Mark Zuckerberg's grey t-shirt, if you will.
Now, what's your favourite holiday destination?
I love Australia. I love Australia. There's just the beaches, but then there's so much more. There's the mountains. There's just so much to do. There's the diving that you can do. I've always loved going to Australia.
Any hilarious incident while travelling that you want to kind of share?
On a honeymoon, my wife and I went to New Zealand. And one of the things I've always wanted to do was bungee jump. So we signed up for this Nevis jump, which is, I think, 135 meters above. My wife refused to come with me. and she was chatting with these ladies just outside the bungee jumping thing, and she said, "We just got married," and they looked at her with absolute horror and said, "Are you completely nuts? What are you thinking? How can you let him jump? What's wrong with you?" She was just laughing, and then when I came back, that's all we were just laughing. They couldn't imagine that somebody would actually go do something so stupid 2 days after they got married.
How was the experience, by the way?
Oh, it was insane. It's probably the scariest thing I've ever done. You jump down, and first of all, I jumped wrong. You're supposed to jump head first, but I jumped feet first.
Oh my.
And then I flipped. Oops. And that was scary. And then my t-shirt covered my head, so I didn't know what was happening. Oh, so and then I plunged into the water. So it was sheer terror. It was good. It was good.
But you not tried it later on?
I haven't. That was my only time. But I have done skydiving. And the funny thing was, once you do bungee jumping, skydiving is actually pretty easy. So that's weird.
Really? Yeah. Oh, okay.
Mostly because you're still strapped to somebody else. So there's this really weird sense. It's a weird sense of security, because if something happens, it's going to happen to both of you, including you. But it's just comforting to have a guy, you know, who feels like he knows what he's doing. So I was less scared when I was skydiving.
What is one thing that you always carry with you?
A pen.
A pen?
I don't know why, because I don't write stuff.
In today's day and age.
It's really weird, right? I don't write stuff anymore. I take notes on my phone. I just carry a pen.
Okay, these are a few of my favorite things. What would they be?
I think my Garmin watch.
Okay.
I love it. It keeps me honest. I think my running shoes, I think.
Are you a brand person?
I'm not a brand person, but I'm very loyal to particular brands because they work well for me. So my Adidas shoes. For example, all the brands that I sell from my company, I'm extraordinarily passionate about them. I love Haagen-Dazs. So Haagen-Dazs is the world's best ice cream. That's the only one that I will ever eat. I'm partial to Zara. I like some of the clothes from Zara.
Who are the people that you can't do without?
My family, my wife and son.
Who would you want to go on a date with? You know, any personality from the past or present?
Charlie Munger. His articles are just like educational. I'd love to just take him out for a Coke. I think he drinks Coke. They want a big steak and Coke, and just talk to him a little bit about life, about thinking, about mental models. Just one of the best thinkers I've ever read.
Is there an Indian or a global business leader you admire?
The one I really admire is maybe a little cliched, but Elon Musk. All right, and I think for two reasons. I think one, he thinks big. He thinks bigger than anybody I've ever seen, right? And just the sheer audacity of his dreams is something I genuinely admire.
Is there a teacher that you haven't forgotten?
But there was one professor in Calcutta called Lina Chatterjee. We called her Lin Chat. She was
at
IIM Cal. She was a professor of organization behavior.
Mm-hmm.
But I think she taught us more about ourselves than we knew about ourselves. And she'll always be one of my favorite profs.
One book that you would recommend, business, non-business?
So there are a number of ones. The one that I really love is How Not to Be Wrong. It's a great book, and it's all about the hidden maths of everyday life. It just opens your mind in terms of how to think about maths. The other one is Poor Charlie's Almanac, and that's again by Charlie Munger.
Mm-hmm.
And it's this big fat collection of his writings and speeches, and that's again fascinating. Yeah.
Okay. Going on, what is the best gift that you received?
It's from my son, actually. And my son, he was supposed to do something in school, and the one person, the essay was the one person I want to spend the most time with.
Mm-hmm.
And he drew my face extraordinarily badly. It didn't look anything like me, but it was my face, and he made sure he wrote my name there. That's I still have that on my bedside table. Yeah.
What's your favorite eating joint?
I love Bombay Canteen. I think it's absolutely terrific food. I think the chef there, Thomas, is absolutely brilliant. And I think what they do with food, the way they think about local recipes, and you know, just getting back into how they kind of combine different recipes and then make it just pop on the plate. I've never had a bad experience there. I love that place.
A particular cuisine that you like?
You know, my go-to cuisine would be always Thai street food. I've never had a bad meal on the streets in Thailand. You go there and then you order, you know, it's just like
meals,
just
They just put
exactly right, some rice and meat and spices. It just tastes delicious.
And you don't know what have you done?
Exactly right. There's no way you can replicate it.
Exactly.
There's no way you can replicate it. There's this little old lady who's doing some complicated stuff, and then it's like Michelin star worthy.
Right.
That's just brilliant.
What's your favorite comfort food?
My favorite comfort food. It's a good question. Biryani.
Biryani?
I like biryani. Yeah. Good biryani is like, it's food
you're
for the gods.
Happy. How is Salil? I mean, if you were to describe, Salil is...
A really simple guy. He's not a very complicated guy.
Okay.
Yeah, it's not like I want a million things. I'm pretty clear. There are a few things that I'd like to be doing.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, that's it. Otherwise,
very focused.
I'm pretty focused, and I think less is more, pretty much.
Would you want your epitaph to read us?
So there's the line that is supposedly inscribed above the gates to the Delphic Oracle, which is Nothi Sitam, which is know thyself, and in ancient Greek, and they consider that the highest form of enlightenment, right? Which is when you truly know yourself, you know the world. You know the world. That would be pretty cool. I'm not saying I'll know myself, but that'd be pretty cool if I had that epitaph.
Thank you so much.
Wonderful. Thank you.
Thank you.